Oh, okay, I guess everyone's fucking pinning me to the wall now.
Got back from Anthony Northwest in Seattle, because I was there for a week. I didn't really announce it either. But just to get the sort of abridged version of it, it was fun and I enjoyed my adventures with friends. And just being out in Seattle, no, it wasn't shit. It was not shit, I promise you that. But either way, Anthony Northwest, I was there. Let's talk about it. Let's go over the fun adventures and pictures that we took and shenanigans we went through with friends. I've got a bunch of stories that happened. I have a lot of new, I don't like calling them fan experiences, but in this case, it is a fan experience. When I mean fan experience, it was not a good one. It was very, what's the word? It wasn't really embarrassing. It was just awkward. I didn't personally feel embarrassed because I'm not responsible for people, but it was just, it was so fucking awkward. And I just got to the point of telling them to fuck off. Which normally I don't do. I'm usually very nice and very patient. But God, just when you make me and so many people around me uncomfortable, I do not tolerate that. But that's me getting ahead of myself, because I have a bunch of pictures that I just loaded onto this computer, and I can totally go over all of them. My timeline from when I left to go to Seattle to coming back home, more or less just Anthony Northwest, because when I was in Seattle, all I really did is, like, hang out with Kyle, Kiwi, Nova, Keat, Raiden, just a couple of other people. It wasn't really like eventful in the sense that we went out and did stuff. Oh, besides Red Robin. I went to Red Robin for the first time ever. Never been to a Red Robin because the only one in like Massachusetts is like in a very bougie and considerably racist area of the state. And I really just don't want to be around that area in general. So I've never been to a Red Robin. Then Raiden was just like, we're taking you to Red Robin. I'm like, okay, I'm going to go to Red Robin. And those bottomless steak fries, they're beautiful. And we did actually go there. We didn't like take out and then just leave because like those bottomless steak fries and bottomless strawberry lemonade. Like, come on, you can't go wrong with that. You just can't go wrong with that. But that was pretty much the highlight outside the con. Hanging out with friends, playing board games. What else? Yeah, that's about it. I kind of just hung out and spent time with friends before the con. I mean, the con was spending time with friends as well, but you get the idea. It's a different environment. Your mom, anyways, let's get on to these wonderful pictures. So before I left, I had a date with Nicolas Cage. We were cuddling and watching Twin Peaks. Very good selfie. Honestly, probably one of the best selfies I've had in a long, long time. Which I'll fucking take that easily. But yeah, I got a nice, had a nice date with Nicolas Cage before I left for Seattle. If you wondered why I wasn't streaming that day, this is what I was doing instead. What's the next picture? This is Keat dead on the couch in Seattle. This was after Red Robin, where we just went back. We all meandered around. We went back to Keat's place. And Raiden wanted to play board games, so we played board games. And Keat just passed out on the couch. All those steak fries. All those steak fries. Bottomless steak fries do that to you. But yeah, Keat, sleepy, passed out. I took a picture of him. It looked so much like the Yamcha dead pose. And I just really wanted to, like, capture it. So I did, and I took a picture. And you have Keat dead. That's pretty much it. This isn't even the con yet. So, you know, we're getting somewhere. We're going to the convention. That's what we're doing. This is when Kyle and Nova drove me up, and we went to the con. And they just dropped me off there with all the luggage, and I just sat in the lobby till they got there. And then I went to get Thai food. There was this this little pop-up Thai restaurant right next to the convention center, right next to the Hyatt. And so I went to get some Thai food. And there's Lyroth. And there's Lyroth. I don't remember taking this photo, but I totally took it at the perfect time because he is just, he's going in on that pad thai. he looks ready. I on a whim took this photo. I didn't even mean it for it to be anything. I just hit capture image and then that's the third image that happened. Him just going the fuck in on that pad thai. And you know what? I don't blame you. That pad thai was good. But yeah, either way, Lyroth, pad thai, very good. This is a Starbucks cafe that costs way too much fucking money for any amount of food or coffee. Just saying. But yeah, more con space stuff. That's like the second floor of the con. There's the back of Keat's head. There's more of the back of Keat's head. I think this was the point where I was just, again, getting B-roll footage with my phone and just hitting the screenshot button while I was recording. Because that's what I'll do sometimes. If I'm already recording, I might as well take pictures. So, took a few screenshots, pictures of the area. And I'm assuming that's why half of these have Keith's head in the background. More outside pictures. More outside pictures. Yeah, that's pretty much me. That's it. Why is he looking directly at me? Holy fuck, that is weird. The fuck are you doing? Fuck off. Go away. Ball pit. This wasn't fucking weird at the con. So here's the thing. I know there was a ball pit at the last Anther Northwest, but the thing is, it was on like the most populated floor of the con. The ball pit here that they had for last year was put in the darkest corner where not too many people were located at the con in the convention space. But seriously, this was uncanny to see. Like, this is the first thing you saw when you went to like the lowest floor in the convention space. There was like, I think 5, 6, and 7 were like the different levels of the con. This was level 5 after we went from 7 to 6 to 5. You come down and then you see this, a random lonely ball pit in the corner of the fucking convention space where there's little to no lighting. I don't think it's foreshadowing of what was to come at the con. It's got a vibe to it. It's like a liminal space photo. It's not really setting a good precedent when you kind of have the ball pit in the darkest corner of the con space and it's just this. I mean, it worked last time in 2019. It was actually like very, very well received in a very lit area, like a very public area where like people were doing things and going places like right outside the dance. This is like on like the least populated floor of the con. Oh yeah, and then I saw Cass and we hung out a bit. And we went to this area where they put together all these box forts. They put like a kingdom of boxes and they have a pound area. We all know that that is not the pound. That is Horny Jail. You just can't put Horny Jail on it because it's in the Northwest. So Cass wanted a picture while being in the pound. But yeah, Cass wanted a picture in the pound and I got a picture of them in the pound. I love that facial expression. That is golden. And they looked lonely in the pound. So I joined them. Look, if your homies are in Horny Jail, you join your homies in Horny Jail, okay? You join them because you want to keep them company. And there I am. just having an existential crisis in the pound. And here we're in Andy's Adventureland. So there was, on the 7th floor, right next to the main stage area where, like, the dance comp and the raves would go, there was another separate area for Andy's Adventureland, which was this little room with all these pool toys and bouncy houses and inflatable slides and all these balloons for fursuiters and people to go around and enjoy. But yeah, it was cozy. Also, they had these little, I guess, badges that you could fill out at near registration with saying like, hello, my fursona is, and then you insert whatever here with like a Sharpie. I put the square hole. The square hole, very good, because you did actually put it in a square. But just like, I don't know, it was at that point in the evening where I thought the convention was going to be kind of boring. Instead of filling in the usual, my fursona is a wagon or G-Ship or Aussie Ship, I just put the square hole. And you know what? People looked at it. And like half of the Gen Z's got it, and then the other ones that were older than them did not get it. They did not get the square hole. Very good. Uncanny picture of the ball pit in a darker area. I swear to God, it got darker the second time I went past it. So yeah, more uncanniness. Next morning, I woke up surprisingly at a reasonable time because my friend Kaji wanted to hang out with me and I didn't have any obligations. So I thought, fuck it. If I can wake up early, I'm gonna get breakfast with Kaji. And then we go to this little tavern, 5 Point Cafe, and I have quite literally the biggest and best chicken fried steak of my life. Anyways, back to outside there. There's the light rail. Looks a lot like fall. I kind of like that. Fall in Seattle is kind of nice. Also, I followed my friends because they were doing fursuit game stuff, but they ended up getting one of those hotel carts for luggage, and they were going to get all the stuff for the fursuit games and take it up to the room to bring to the con space when they needed it for the Saturday morning. And Omnom decided to ride it, and I took pictures of Omnom riding it. It looked like fun, and I was kind of jealous because I wanted to ride on it. But hey, you know, it's pretty easy to take it. Like, Kiwi's just like one-arming it. Look, like, it's like a parent dragging their child. The energy in this, so good. Yeah, more pictures of that. Going through, me back on the elevator, taking a selfie with Kyle. This is actually a nice set of pictures. I dig it. Sip. Me and Kyle had some good pictures together. Mr. Bubbles, got to see them. This was still Friday evening-ish. And I went to go and get dinner with Kate and Iso and a bunch of other friends because I just wanted some food and they were going to get some good food in Seattle. And they always know where the good food in Seattle is. They wanted to go to like Rondo's or something. Everything was packed because it was Friday night before Thanksgiving weekend. So yeah, but hey, I got to put one of my stickers on a crossing walk post. I didn't actually put it up there. Our friend Iso, who was taller than me, put it up there. Now there's a Levi-gasm hanging on 150 something street by one of the crosswalks that I don't think anyone's ever going to get down. But I had a spare gasm sticker that I gave to Iso, and then he just slapped it up there and it just kind of stuck up there. Don't know if it's still there, but I hope it is. Ah, yes! My favorite food! Motion blur! and low shutter speed. Love it! But yeah, we ended up settling on some sort of Mexicali restaurant that Iso said was good. And I got, like, the trio of street tacos. But before that, I had a drink known as a margarita. It was, like, an agave margarita. And you all know what they say about margaritas. One tequila, two tequila, three tequila, four. Tequila is not nice to you. It is always angry. And it was angry to me, and I had one drink. And there's Keith just eating a tortilla. And I can't remember how intoxicated it was, but I only had one drink. I was just like tipsy. I don't know what happened to me. And then I went home after that, I think. Because I took some pictures of like where my stickers were from last time. They lasted a month, 2 months at this point. Pretty good. And that was my Friday at the con. Not really that eventful. Didn't fursuit once. And then the next day, I'm just getting all the pictures of all these fursuiters at the pound at Horny Jail. But took some pictures of them. They wanted pictures. What happened next after this? I can't remember Saturday too much. I think the tequila really did like knock me the fuck out. Oh, okay. So this is a weird jump. But I got an amazing fucking badge from someone who just on a whim made one for me. Of my Aussie ship. This fucking badge is so cute. Before the con, they asked me, like, hey, do you want me to make you a badge for the con? I'm like, sure, I'd love a badge for Aussie ship beta. My only request is to put them in a life jacket. And they're like, you got it. I can do that easily. And they just did it on a whim. And they were about to leave the con. And they were messaging me, like, hey, I'm going to be leaving later today. Can I, like, hand off the badge to you? And holy fuck, it's so good. But, like, shout out to Smaxbur for making this badge for me. It's so fucking good. And I love it so much. So one thing that you'll notice throughout a couple of these pictures that I take is that Anthro Northwest the con is, it's kind of a dedication to Andy, as in their mascot, like Andy, whatever Andy, whoever Andy is, the persona character. But yeah, Fort Andy. And I don't want to overthink that as being very cultish. I want to think that this is very much like a con pandering to young kids. The point is, Kyle wanted to go to Fort Andy, and now you get a big picture of what that fort looks like. It's a big box house, and then the horny jail is over to the left. And that's that, Andy's toy box. Please return toys to the box when finished. But that's Andy, the fursona, the mascot of the con. You'll see this a lot. You'll see the Kigu that I got of the con from the con last time was of Andy. You can get a Kigu of Andy from the con store. This was the dance. This was the rave that Saturday night. That was it. This is like midnight too. Yeah. Yeah. I looked in there and I walked back out. I felt a bit bad. Oh, that looks even worse. I think I zoomed in. I forgot that I zoomed in from the back of the room. That doesn't look any better. Oh no, it's even worse now. Back to the ball pit. You know, it looks a bit better now. When you look back at the old picture of it looking all dark and, you know, a rave. The ball pit looks a bit better now. Not as uncanny. I mean, it does look uncanny when you don't have anything else around it. But it's still, you know, it looks a bit better in hindsight. Okay, here's my picture that Nova took for me. This is the entire fucking hallway. So fucking cool. The design looked good. Perfect for photos. I decided, you know what? Even though I don't have my fursuit, I want a fucking photo in this hallway. So I thought, okay, what would be a good vibe right now? So I looked up old man meme picture Squid Game. And you know that one of like the old man in Squid Game just looking like completely like defeated, just done with everything in the corner? I decided I wanted to replicate that picture. And that is what I did. And I got it from a side angle and Nova took it from me. And then a close up. Not gonna lie, that's actually a really good picture of me. minus the fact that it looks like I haven't showered in like 3 days, which I have showered, trust me. I'm just very moist in general, but it's still a good photo and I love it. And you know, this is kind of like what PCD looks like. This is another highlight of my con. I ran into Zephyr. They, during the pandemic, got a Morpholess suit with the big tum. The big and round inflatable tum, like you see that Zul has. Because Morpholess is just able to do it now. So they said, eh, fuck it, sure, we'll do it for you if you want. And Zephyr got it. Look at that tum. Look at this good bean. Aw, this is just adorable. Okay, minus the whole, like, thirst for the tum. This is sweet. This is just a nice big hug, a nice big picture that I got with Zephyr. So cute! I love it. Oh, and then this. This is just a solid jump. But, yeah, Zephyr kind of pinned me to a wall with his tum. That was interesting. Surprised he didn't get kicked out of the con. But you know what? It was nice. Oh, okay, I guess everyone's fucking pinning me to the wall now. This con, what happened? What happened? How did all of a sudden my friends just start pinning me to the wall? It just doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. But, okay, I'm forgetting something. There was a little bit of a time lapse between this point and the next photo with Keat, or set of photos. So, this is sort of a story time. And this is adding to the 10 crazy furry convention moments that I've had. So there's this thing that people have started doing as a means of sort of moving their way into conversing with me when they like want to say hi to me or meet me at a con. They want to meet Maverick, they want to meet Beta, whatever they call it. Some people are genuine with it. Some people are trying to be subtle about it, but come off as being, And what some people will do, and this isn't me trying to be an asshole about, like, people trying to see me. You can say hi to me however you want. But what people have started to do is the thing of, like, I think I've seen you somewhere before. Have I seen you somewhere before? And they'll keep asking that until you answer who you are. When in reality, you've got your fucking badges on you, or you're wearing a fursuit of you, which at the time, at this point in time when the photo was taken, whatever, I was in Maverick, going around with Maverick, and I had my badges for Maverick. And on the back, there was one for Beta, which was my Aussie ship, which was me. People are just, some people do that, like genuinely some people don't know who I am, and they're just like, wait, I think I've seen you before. Are you on like YouTube or TikTok? But they'll usually have that sort of like jump into it. Most people will just be like, I think I've seen you before, and that was it. And they'll wait for you to answer it. And it's just a weird way of them just like saying hi and making it a bit uncomfortable for me. So I was with friends and I was literally while in suit joking about this. Like, I think I've seen you somewhere before. After I did that, came up and did that to me. They're just like, I think I've seen you somewhere before. I look at him and then I look at Lyroth, who's recording for me, and he gives me a look. And I know exactly, we're thinking the same thing of like, you can't be serious. So they're like, I think I've seen you somewhere before. I'm like, maybe, can't really say. And then I showed him my badges or whatever. He's like, but I feel like I've seen you somewhere before. Repeats it again, even though I showed him my badges and name or whatever. And I've never, ever had this happen before. But they pulled out their phone and they pulled up one of my videos. They pulled up one of my shorts, the Beta Shorts channel, and they played it full volume. In front of me, in front of so many other people who are looking to potentially say hi or like fursuit around with me. I was with Zephyr, I was with Lyroth, and a couple other people. They played it full fucking volume in front of me asking, is this you? I'm like, yeah, that's me. Like in a very like uncomfortable tone of just like, hey, let's not do that now. Like, yeah, that's me. Hi, I'm yeah. And they're like, oh, Mr. Delota, hello. As if I wasn't already like taken aback by having someone literally play my videos in front of me. They just full on call me Mr. Delota. And I'm like, yeah, what's up? Hi. And I was just trying as quickly as I could to end that conversation as soon as it started. Like, I just didn't want to continue whatever was happening there. And I was just trying to like walk off and do whatever. And they just kept trying to talk to me of like, how's your con doing? Do you know Majira Strawberry? Do you know Mr. Strawberry? And I don't even know what they wanted at that point. I think they wanted a picture, but they weren't really telling me that, but they didn't say anything. But I just kind of at that point, like got distracted because Zephyr was asking me to do something. So I turn around and interact with Zephyr a bit more and he's like running off to do something. So I'm chasing after him. And this is like in the span of 20 seconds, this all happens. I'm just like doing whatever with him. The dude that was saying hi to me goes off and does whatever, or I assume he does. So I go to chasing after Zephyr, and out of the corner of my eye, the dude comes following back up and continues holding up his phone, chasing after me while playing the video on full volume of another short that he was playing. He's like, "This is you, yes, right?" And at that point, I was done. I'm not humoring people like that. So I, for the first time, and I don't like doing this, I turn around and I'm just like, "Yes, that is me. Fuck off." Just full on said that. And he was like, "Oh," then he walked away. Now, I know some people will probably disagree with me saying that and me being rather harsh, snappy. It was me snapping at them to an extent. But at the same time, I made it as clear as day that I was done with the conversation to begin with. Whatever interaction we had, I just wanted it done with, and do not talk to me anymore, please. And that was it. They didn't interact with me again, which was good. But whenever my other friends came down, like Nova, when Nova came down in suit, when Kyle came down in suit, when other friends came down in suit, he would just go up to them and follow them around and just start like talking to them, or they call him like Mr. Strawberry. But like, I think at some point I was outside with Nova on like the balcony. We were like cooling off during this suiting session. And he came up to Nova and was like, "Hey, do you know that you're a husky?" And then Nova ignored it, and then he waited 30 seconds and asked the question again, louder before. "Hey, do you know that you're a husky?" And Nova's like, "Yeah, I do." And then he's like, "Oh, I didn't expect that response," and then walked away. I talked to Nova later and asked, like, "Would you have responded differently if you were in my mindset?" Nova was like, "Yes, I would have." And they were like, if it went down a different way, they would have been like, as soon as they asked, like, "Hey, do you know that you're a husky?" Nova wanted to turn around and be like, "Hey, do you know that you're annoying?" I mean, that's just... But it's just, I can guarantee the response would have been the same of like, "Oh, I wasn't expecting that." But it's just like, dude, why are people this way? I try to be, in most of these situations where people do this, I try to be nice. Tell them, "Hey, I don't want, goodbye. And they just don't get it. So I just have to full send it now, because I just don't like humoring this sort of behavior. And it is parasocial behavior. It's very, very parasocial behavior. And like, most people don't do that. They don't follow people around. But still, point being, that was probably the most uncomfortable I've been in a fursuiting situation like that. Just being there and being put on the spot and having my videos played in front of me full volume with people around and being chased around with it. Like, yeah, no. Where it's not even just like I go and hide in my room or go and hide in the headless lounge. I'm telling you to fuck off. Like, I just don't care. I don't know what, like, how that even comes to be is like, yes, this is okay to do, and I should do this, and I should follow them around playing their video. Like, just most of the time, people, when they said hi to me, again, this goes back to the thing, 99% of the people that said hi to me or wanted to get a picture with me were chill. They said hi, they wanted a picture, they asked for a picture, I got a picture with them, they were patient when I said, "Hey, I'm doing something right now, give me like 30 seconds, they were just fine. They didn't hover. They didn't stay within like my field of view or follow me around. They wanted the picture. They said hi. They wanted the hug. I gave the hug. And they were like, have a good con. And they got what they were looking for. They didn't extend it any further. That is 99% of people. That 1% of people was that person that went, "I think I've seen you somewhere before," and then played my video in front of everyone. God, now reminiscing on that makes me somewhat pissed off. The point is, that wasn't really like the big thing that happened at Anthro Northwest. I had like good experiences with it, but like, I'm personally adding that story and that experience to my list of 10 crazy furry convention experiences. But anyways, back to the rest of Anthro Northwest. After that experience, I just continued doing my thing, and you know what? It was a lot better. Either way, just some more cute fursuit photos. That was pretty much the rest of this con for me, going around in suit, hanging out with friends, and that's about it, honestly. Cute fursuits, us giving like little hearts, trying to do it with our big pobs because we couldn't do that. And then the ball pit was gone. Literally, after we finished fursuiting, we went back downstairs and the ball pit was gone. This is all that was left, an empty corner where that ball pit once remained. And so Nova and Kyle and I had a perfect idea. We decided to take a chair and put ourselves in the corner of that room and take pictures from it. And you know what? It worked. Sure. Because Nova looks great. I think I got some photos. The fetal position. Yep, that's it. What about me? I think I have my photos coming up. Yep. Well, there I am. What does it look like closer?
It looks even better when you zoom in.
Okay, for context to this image, I didn't know that picture was behind me, but Kyle told me to make a face like, and so I decided to go like just full send on it and made that. I had no clue that that was behind me. That is Anthem Northwest in a nutshell. I mean, minus, you know, the actual con footage, which I don't know how much of it is actually, like, good footage, because I was just kind of enjoying the con for what it was. Either way, it was a small con. It was short. Overall, I did have a good time at Anthem Northwest, though. It was fun to just see friends again and not really have too many obligations besides having to poop every so often. But other than just going around and seeing fursuiters and just exploring the con space at times where you think people would be around when they aren't, there was nothing really else to do. So that's why I just tagged along with some friends and just explored the city or did whatever else because, hey, you're in Seattle. For what it was worth, wasn't what I expected it to be compared to 2019 Anthem Northwest, but overall, I had a good time. I can't complain.